Hey everyone! In this video, we will be learning how to use Webform Analytics for your business. Webform Analytics in Zoho CRM is aimed to help you understand how the forms in your web pages are performing. It analyzes the visitor engagement with the form in terms of countries where it performs well, which fields are most frequently filled, the number of users who submitted the form, conversion rate, that is, the number of users that clicked on the form to the number of users who submitted them, lead conversion rate, revenue generated, and much more. Let's take the case of Zilker Technologies. In their web pages, they have four web forms created with Zoho CRM: a signup form, a registration form, a contact us form, and a feedback form. Now let's go to Zoho CRM to understand the performance of these web forms. Go to Setup, Developer Space, Web Forms. Here, you will have a list of web forms that are created and the ones that are active on your web page. The overall analytics for the module selected in this dropdown is shown here. Visits constitutes the number of users who visited the web form. Starters represent the number of users who started filling up your form. And submissions represent the number of users who submitted the form. Based on the visits to starters ratio, you can see the drop in engagement in your web form. And based on the visitors to submissions ratio, you can see the conversion rate. When we click on More Stats, you can see the comparison across all web forms in the Leads module. In Zilker's case, Contact Us, Signup Form, Registration Form. Now, hover here, and you can see the visits, unique visitors, starters, submissions, and conversion rate. Unique visitors will eliminate the same user leaving the browser open and visiting again. If he or she closes the web page and visits it again, he will be considered another visitor. Similarly, you can hover over and see the stats for the other forms as well. For a better visual representation, the same analytics is available in the tabular format also. As we scroll down, you can see the submissions based on country. This will help you understand where your leads are coming from and in which countries your web form is performing well. In Zilker's case, you can see that the top country which engages with the form is India. This is mentioned here. Based on this information, you can customize the forms to cater to the audience from those countries and improve their engagement with other country users as well. The same data is available in the tabular format too. Let's scroll down and you can see the leads, converted leads, and deals based on forms. This will show the number of leads created by each form that became a closed deal. Here in the signup form, you can see that the number of leads created is 55, and the number of leads converted and deals are 42. The number of closed won deals is 23, and the number of closed lost deals is 19. You can see these stats for each form. Next, we have the revenue based on forms. As the name suggests, it throws light on the amount of revenue generated by the deals created as a result of the form submission. Here, you can filter the analytics data for any time duration for which you want to see the analytics. It can be the current week, month, or for 100 days, or a custom duration of your choice. Say we choose current week. The current revenue generated for that week will be the current revenue. Previous revenue will have the overall revenue of the previous week, and based on this growth rate will be calculated. We saw how we can view analytics for web forms in different modules. For individual web form analytics, let's go to the previous page. When you hover over a particular form, you can see the View Analytics option. There are different ways to publish a web form. By adding it as a source code in the website, by embedding the form or in an iframe format. If you have used the embed or iframe format, tracking will be automatically enabled in Zoho CRM by clicking on the Enable Tracking option right here. But if you've used the source code, then you have to paste the tracking code along with your source code to begin tracking. Let's see this follow-up form here. You can see the Enable Tracking option. Once you click on that, the tracking code will readily be available. You have to paste this along with the code in the web page where you have the form. Once that's done, Tracking is enabled for the form, and you can start getting analytics information. In addition to this, analytics will also be automatically enabled for newly created web forms. Now, let's see how an individual's web form analytics will look. Let's see Zilker's signup form analytics. You can see the submissions data for the form. You can see the analytics for the day, week, or month, the number of starters, number of submissions, the conversion rate will be shown here. But to understand how the user has interacted with the form, we can get a clearer picture on partial versus complete submissions. This will analyze, even in the number of form submissions, how many users have filled in the fields in the form and how many users have filled only selected fields. To take this further, you can see fields filled rate. This will show analytics on each field. It shows the percentage of users who have submitted the form who filled each field. Based on this information, you can remove irrelevant fields from your form and get a complete conversion. Fields filled rate analytics is available for Ultimate Edition in Zoho CRM. Next, you can see analyze the performance of the forms in different regions. We can see how the submissions work in Zoho CRM. Not all of the submissions in different web forms become records in Zoho CRM. Here, you can see the number of submissions and the number of submissions waiting for approval if there is an approval process associated with the form. Double opt-in is when an organization might have preferred to get the email in the form submission verified before making a record in Zoho CRM in order to filter out unauthentic leads. You can see the number of users waiting for such double opt-in here. You can also keep a tab on the duplicate submissions. If there is already a lead with a particular email ID and we have a form submission with the same email ID, it will be marked as a duplicate. If you have validation rules in CRM for particular records, the fields in the form will be checked for the available validation rules. If the validation rules are not met, then it will not be converted. Here, it shows the number of leads and the number of converted leads. Next, we can see the lead conversion report. This shows the number of leads created based on form submissions that were converted. Next, we can see the deals created report. This is the same thing that we saw before. It shows the number of deals that were created after lead conversion and the number of deals won and lost. And finally, we have the revenue generated report based on deals closed from that particular form. Gathering all of these analyses will help make the necessary changes in the web forms to improve the form conversion rate. That's all about web form analytics. For more resources on Zoho CRM, visit www.zoho.com/crm.